In Exodus 2, Moses, when he's in Midian, he joins the family of Jethro, and the first thing he does is an act of rescuing. There were these shepherds who drive away the daughters of Jethro, and Moses intervenes and looks after them, these members of that ancient church family. He straight away intervenes, like he'd done earlier with the Hebrews in Egypt. He intervened to protect these church people from pagan bullies. So he does it again, and then they bring him back home to meet Jethro, and they say how kind he'd been, and then they break bread together, and Moses agrees to live there, and Jethro gives him Zipporah to marry, and he marries Zipporah, who is this Midianite. Now, we'll look at the child they have next time, but let's just spend a little bit of time on Zipporah. She's such an important person. We'll see how she saves Moses' life quite soon. We'll see that. But there's quite a lot of things to note about her. So here she's called a Midianite. But when we go to look in Numbers chapter 12, if you read Numbers chapter 12, you'll see that Zipporah, the wife of Moses, is Ethiopian, a Cushite. So at first we think, well, how can she be an Ethiopian with black skin? That's the whole issue in Numbers 12. Miriam and Aaron don't like that he's married a black African. And so the Lord is really angry about Miriam and Aaron because they object to this. And so he curses Miriam's skin to become leprously white. So it's a judgment on her skin because she is objecting to the wife of Moses. It's a chapter that I constantly go back to because it speaks so powerfully that the Lord will not have any of that prejudice about a person on the basis of their skin color. He will not. And Numbers 12 is very, very strong on that. But Moses, his wife, Zipporah, is there described as an Ethiopian. So we're thinking, how can this be? How can she be both a Midianite on the Arabian Peninsula, but also an Ethiopian? Well, one of the things that helps us is in Habakkuk 3, verse 7, we see there that the tents of Cush and the dwellings of Midian are joined together. And we do know that this Midianite empire, or put it the other way, the Ethiopian empire, the Sheban empire, stretches from Ethiopia, Eritrea, as we know it today, and into the Arabian Peninsula. There's a kind of shared empire and community at many times, and that goes on for hundreds of years. And of course, in early church history, the Ethiopian empire stretches into Arabia. So it's clear that she can be a Cushite and a Midianite, and that tells us something about who Jethro also had married and all of those things. So that's one important thing to notice about Zipporah. And perhaps we'll just focus on that for a moment, that for Moses, here when he marries her, her skin colour or the fact that she's from Cush, Ethiopian, isn't even mentioned at all. For Moses, that isn't something that he thinks he needs to report here. But later in Numbers 12, it all comes out. And I think that's tremendously important, that for Moses, his great vision of church as being this international family where all nations are welcome, and we'll see that more in the book of Exodus, that people of all kinds of nationalities join in the Exodus, and Moses understands that. He's this great church leader, and for him, all the nations of the world must be gathered into church, and everyone is one family with all the diversity of languages and tribes and cultures. We'll see more of that as we explore church in the book of Exodus. But it almost begins so powerfully that in a way these Hebrews had come from Asia. They're now in North Africa. Moses himself has this kind of background with Hebrew and Egyptian, and he's married this Cushite, this Ethiopian. It's all part of this wonder that is church. Church is a very international place with lots of different languages, lots of different skin colors. Most of us, our church family has lots of people of lots of different cultures, skin colors, languages. We're used to that, but it's something which the world in general really struggles with in different ways. And it just reminds us how the Lord's vision of church is this wonderful international family.